Tonight on News 5 Live, Andrew Perez returns as the Minister of Blue Economy. The Prime Minister says the decision was made on the heels of an overwhelming mandate at the polls. What Perez told News 5 today. Teachers prepare to select a new national president as the BNTU holds its annual convention. Blade and 12 return to court will have the latest. And a 7.4 magnitude earthquake rattles Taiwan. We'll speak to a Belizean living there about her experience. These stories and more coming up on News 5 Live.
For 19 years, SMART has been the pulse of our nation. A journey of growth, innovation, resilience, and unity.
From the first call that bridged distances to the data that brought us closer than ever, SMART has been there, weaving threads of connection across our beautiful land.
We have been active in providing innovative solutions to enhance our customers' lifestyles. Over the years, SMART has developed and provided various services to meet customers' needs.
To the dreamers, doers, and the believers, thank you for making SMART a part of your story. For 19 years of trust, loyalty, partnership, and shared experiences.
As we celebrate 19 years of connecting lives and dreams, let's keep the rhythm alive. Together, let's continue to shape our future one connection at a time.
Come and be a part of the SMART family, where we empower you and our country today, tomorrow, and beyond.
SMART, bringing people together.
My name is Leomar Langsert, and I'm a teacher, and I bank with Belize Bank Independence Branch. What I enjoy is the safety features that the app offers. I have a sense of not having to worry or be concerned about somebody finding my password and username to sign in the application because of the use of the one-time password. And another feature that I love, that I use the most, is how the app synchronizes with my fingerprint on my device. I enjoy the rapid and easy, seamless process to apply for loans through the Belize Bank, and I don't have to be having too much back and forth to visit or take time to visit the bank. They also start to offer the online applications through the app for loan applications, which I believe is very neat. I would definitely recommend Belize Bank to other teachers because one of all the features and advantages that the app offer with this online that Belize Bank offered is basically everything that you can do in the palm of your hand. So I would definitely recommend the bank to other teachers.
Discover a shopping experience like no other at the V Department Store. They carry a vast array of products at unbeatable prices. Elevate your shopping journey with affordability, diversity, and accessibility at the V. Conveniently located at 1745 Coney Drive in Belize City.
2,251,000 slices of watermelon are eaten by tourists each year in Belize, benefiting local farmers and processors directly. Tourism means business.
This podcast is brought to you by the Belize Bank Limited, our country, your bank. Good evening and welcome to News 5 Live for Wednesday, April 3rd. I am Sabrina Daly. Prime Minister John Briceño announced today that Belize Rural South Area Representative Andre Perez is returning to cabinet as the Minister of Blue Economy and Disaster Risk Reduction. Perez now assumes control of the National Emergency Management Organization, NEMO, and the National Fire Service. This announcement comes 4 weeks after the municipal elections and more than 7 months after Perez went on leave following allegations of sexual misconduct. Those allegations were levied by female attorney Wendy Ogzalu. When asked for comment, Minister Perez told News 5, quote, "I thank the Prime Minister for his decision to invite me back to cabinet and will work hard every day for the Belizean people, especially the good people of Belize Rural South," end of quote. As for requests for an update to the investigation, Attorney General Anthony Sylvester told us that the request would have to be made to the office of the Prime Minister. But one portfolio that Paris does not get back is civil aviation, which now falls under the purview of the Prime Minister. Paris was one of the persons who led the PUP to victory in San Pedro town on March 6th. Also, Cayo Central Area Representative Alex Balona is now the Minister of State in the Ministry of Agriculture, Food Security and Enterprise. Belize Rural North Area Representative Marconi Leal is now the Minister of State in the Ministry of Infrastructure Development and Housing. Cayo West Area Representative is now the Minister of State in the Ministry of Investment. The Office of the Prime Minister says, quote, "These adjustments and assignments come on the heels of an overwhelming mandate at the polls, a reminder not only of the confidence and trust in this government, but also of the tremendous responsibility we have to the people of Belize," end quote. The Belize National Teachers Union is gearing up to conduct a by-election to elect a national president. Jorge Mejia was appointed acting president in September of last year, following Ruth Showman's controversial resignation. The election of a new national president is scheduled for Wednesday in Belmopan. Today, BNTU members gathered at the Our Lady of Guadalupe High School compound for their 54th annual convention. There we spoke with Mejia about the activities scheduled for the two-day event.
First of all, we're having our 54th annual convention, BNTU, and then today we're having the business of the union. And at the moment, we'll be reviewing our constitution, which is important for our members. Tomorrow, it will be crucial. We'll be having an election, a by-election for our national president, and it is very important for us, our members, to come tomorrow to exercise their democratic right, which is to elect the next national president of BNTU.
How do we ensure transparency and fairness in the process? Because while it is a union thing, the union collaborates strongly with the general public.
We have an excellent team, which is the election committee that oversees the entire process.
Okay.
And so tomorrow, if you want to know, you could come tomorrow and you'll get the result after the elections.
Yeah. How important is it to have your members come out in full force to vote?
Definitely, because it's their right. So they need to come and exercise, because the person who chooses will lead us, our members, for the future.
As you heard, the Belize National Teachers Union will be electing a new national president on Thursday. Two members are vying for the position. They are Ifashina Efunemi and Nadia Kalis. We sought to speak with both candidates today in Belmopan. Kalis denied our request for an interview, but says she has nothing to hide and will grant an interview after Thursday's election. Efunemi, on the other hand, was willing to speak. She is one of the three candidates who lost to Ruth Showman in April of 2023. This by-election gives her another chance at the presidency, and she says that she is feeling very confident this time around.
I am feeling very confident. I am feeling calm. I know and have a lot of faith in the members of the BNTU. At the end of the day, the members, they get the leaders they deserve. It's just like with democracy overall. People get the leaders they deserve because they get the leaders they choose. And even if they don't make themselves available and are not present for choosing, they still end up with whoever is chosen by those who go and make that decision on their behalf. So I want to appeal to members to be fully present. It's imperative that we are here. We claim to be the defenders of democracy. We are key in this democracy that is in Belize. We establish a balance in our nation and hold our government accountable. This is why we saw to it that the UN Convention Against Corruption was signed and that we had a 13th senator. The BNTU was a big part of ensuring that those things happened. So, to whom much is given, much is expected. Our responsibility is tremendous, but we have to be fully present. It cannot be the minority that makes the decision. However, if you forfeit your right, your voice, it will be the minority that will make the decision.
We also asked candidate Ifashina Efuniemi for her thoughts on comments Education Minister Francis Fonseca made 2 weeks ago against the union's executive inside the National Assembly. In his remarks, Minister Fonseca said that there are still a few UDPs who want to create mischief before the municipal elections. He was referring to the BNTU's press conference on March 5th in Belmopan. Acting President Jorge Mejia declined to comment, but Efuniemi says that Minister Fonseca is doing what politicians do, misleading and disseminating misinformation. Here is how she puts it.
The minister was being a politician, and he was doing what politicians do. Politricians, that's why there's that coining of the term politricians, because then when they're playing that game, the whole point is to mislead, actually, by giving misinformation. The conference that happened the day before was led by the Council of Management of the Belize National Teachers Union. And while our political affiliation is actually a constitutional right, the Belize National Teachers Union is not a political party and has to fight fervently to ensure that none of the parties, so that no partisan politics undermines the strength of the union, which is our struggle right now, because we have members who, yes, have their alliance with their different parties, but their allegiance happens to be to their political party. And if that is the case, then that is where we might have some problems in our union.
Coming up, Belizeans experience 7.4 magnitude earthquake in Taiwan.
Tell me, what about Aono today?
I recently do a Red Girl video. I get more views than Harriet. And you know one person had the nerve to post that I do not even a Red Girl? I mean, like, what that mean anyway?
Well, hear what about me? Every time I go buy meat pie, and I go, so, nothing to in there. Nothing.
So this is my issue. I over 18. I don't want no one artist. Are you gonna believe mama still expect me for wash dishes?
No get time for that. I don't prefer
dishes.
Yes.
And you, sir?
Well, I don't really got their kind of problems, you know. Ever since I switched to DJ and signed up for my unlimited postpaid plan, life stress-free. Nothing bother me or my connection no more.
Past 3 years, Belmopan was the worst failed PUP local government under a failed PUP central government. And in their new term, they are only getting worse. They have now appointed a financial director for Belmopan that is an accused thief. He is Flavio Salam, who, as an accountant for Santander back in August 2018, was charged with embezzlement of $219,000, almost $250,000. This John Briceño PUP will not change for the better. They will only get worse.
I don't care what anybody says.
Belizeans, we must stand against them. We must get rid of them. The PUPs have to go. We'll be right back.
Get ready for the most anticipated event of the year, Miss Universe Belize 2024. On Saturday, April 13th, starting at 8 p.m. Tickets are exclusively available at Smart Showrooms countrywide. General admission starts at $25, reserve tickets at $50, and VIP tickets at $100. Get the Ultra VIP package experience for only $1,000. To secure your Ultra VIP tickets, simply email the Miss Universe Belize Foundation at mubelizeinfo@gmail.com. Remember, the dress code is formal cocktails, so dress to impress. Catch all the excitement of Miss Universe Belize 2024 streaming live exclusively on the national channel, and it's also available on Next Gen TV. The red carpet starts at 7:30 p.m. and the show starts at 8 p.m. Don't miss out on this unforgettable evening. It's so good, it's so good.
Here's how to be a part of Benny's Home Cation in 3 easy steps. First, download the V-Bucks app and sign up to be eligible. It's fast and easy. Then, shop at any Benny's location or Benny's entity. Remember to choose products from our monthly Homecation jackpot categories to earn entries. Now you can earn V-Bucks with purchases made and be a part of the Benny's Homecation jackpot for a chance to win the $10,000 grand prize in December. Win the ultimate Homecation with Benny's, quality and savings.
For 19 years, SMART has been the pulse of our nation. A journey of growth, innovation, resilience, and unity.
From the first call that bridged distances to the data that brought us closer than ever, SMART has been there, weaving threads of connection across our beautiful land.
We have been active in providing innovative solutions to enhance our customers' lifestyles. Over the years, SMART has developed and provided various services to meet customers' needs.
To the dreamers, doers, and the believers, thank you for making SMART a part of your story. For 19 years of trust, loyalty, partnership, and shared experiences.
As we celebrate 19 years of connecting lives and dreams, let's keep the rhythm alive. Together, let's continue to shape our future one connection at a time.
Come and be a part of the SMART family, where we empower you and our country today, tomorrow, and beyond.
SMART, bringing people together.
The voir dire in the case of the Bladen 12 resumed today at the Charles Bartlett Hyde Building in Belize City. The 12 men are facing trial for the landing of a drug plane on the Southern Highway on November 5th of 2021. The prosecution called its fifth and sixth witnesses today in the persons of a police corporal and a justice of the peace. Head of prosecutions, attorney Alifa Ellerington, called Corporal Jose U this morning. A constable at the time, recorded a caution statement from one of the accused, Moises Perez. The defense is claiming that several of the defendants were beaten or threatened while in police custody following the discovery and seizure of the plane. In court today, much of the argument centered on whether Moises Perez was abused in any way. The JP, Martin Kahl, was present during the recording of that statement and said he spent a few minutes alone with Perez before he gave the statement. Today, the senior magistrate presiding over the matter admitted Perez's statements so that the court can determine at the end of this voir dire whether any of the defendants were coerced, beaten, or in any way abused to give their statements. We spoke first to one of the defense attorneys, Leroy Banner, and then to the head of the prosecution's branch, Alifa Ellerington.
The person who recorded the caution statement testified today, and it was tendered. So she does mark it to say it is entered into evidence.
But what does that mean? Because at the end of the voir dire, she will decide whether the caution statement will be accepted into evidence, is what we understand.
Yeah, that is so. So at this stage, it's just, we're going through the process, then she will decide, now hearing both sides, if if it was given freely and voluntarily, then she will admit into evidence formally. So right now it is tendered into evidence. And if she decides that, okay, I'm satisfied that it was given freely in compliance with the Evidence Act now, I would admit it. But at this stage now, we're not at that stage as yet.
She also said that she is not looking at the content right now. What does that mean?
Okay, that means because when it comes to a caution statement, what is important is not the truth of the caution statement. What is important is that when the police got the statement, was it given freely? Was the person beaten? Was he threatened? Those are the questions. So it's not per se if it's the truth. We're not concerned about the truth. We are concerned if the police follow the Evidence Act. Was there any force? Was there any inducement? Was there any premise? Today we focus on Mr. Pavis' statement. He gave us two statements on the 5th and 6th of November 2021. So those are the statements we are being challenged.
Defense has been alleging or is suggesting that they were beaten and beaten and beaten for all the time that they were in police custody, and therefore they had no other reason but to give these statements because the police were beating them and beating them and beating them. I believe that on the last occasion I told the court that we would have about 10 witnesses for the voir dire. So if we're at about 6, then I have about 4 more witnesses.
Throughout much of today, the defense based its arguments on the premise that there was police abuse committed against the defendants. This afternoon, the prosecution called J.P. Martin Cowell to testify. He told the court that the statement of defendant Moises Perez was taken in his presence, during which the police constable Jose U offered him food and water. However, the defense suggested to Cal that he did not ask the defendant whether he was abused prior to the recording of the statement. The cross-examination process, as Ellerington explained, can be a tedious one. She addressed that matter as well as an allegation that defendant Elmer Na made.
National Forensic Science Service, Mr. Cho was one of the co-chairs along with 2 justices of the High Court, and we were supposed to be looking at the National Forensic Science Service and how it relates to the criminal justice system. What are the difficulties that we all face and how it is that we can make it better?
The very last thing I wanted to ask, on the previous occasion, one of the accused had complained about his transportation detail from the prison. I don't believe it's under your purview. I'm not sure you could clarify, but the senior magistrate had said that it's a matter to be addressed through PSB. I think you may have some involvement, but was that addressed?
So technically, prosecution branch is responsible for the transporting of prisoners. Ordinarily, what would happen is that the prison would bring down prisoners in the morning, and then my office is responsible to transport prisoners back in the afternoon. Because this is a very high profile case, as Mr. Bradley has said 10 countless times in interview, and we're dealing with a high profile defendant, we have had to add security measures in the transporting of those 2 prisoners. So what has happened is that GI3 is assisting in the transporting of those 2 prisoners for this particular case. Defense counsel Mr. Jones did get up and did say to the court that his client made certain complaints to him. Based on what was said, I indicated to the court that in as much as it is that he is making that for the court's knowledge, the proper procedure, if it is that he's having a difficulty with a police officer or a police officer is doing something that he's not required to do or he's not expected to do as a police officer, the proper procedure was to make an official complaint through the Professional Standards Bureau of the Belize Police Department. After that complaint was made, I subsequently got certain information as it relates to the actual transportation. So there is actual video footage of the full transportation of Mr. Na when he was picked up at the prison, when he was escorted out the prison doors
into the prison van, and the prison van is actually secured also with video cameras at the front and at the back. So his entire transportation while he was on that prison board, on that prison van, was also recorded.
Taiwan was rattled by a 7.4 magnitude earthquake. This is the strongest tremor that has hit the island nation in more than 25 years. At least 9 persons have been confirmed dead, with hundreds more injured. Authorities have issued warnings of potential aftershocks in the coming days. Many Belizeans are in Taiwan, and News 5's Hippolyta Novello spoke to one of them.
Belizean teacher living in Taiwan, Melody Wagner, recounted the moment she felt her building shaking. She was on the 19th floor when the island nation was hit by a 7.4 magnitude earthquake at around 8 a.m. local time on Wednesday.
Well, immediately, like, I had to kind of regulate myself a bit, because I thought it was just dizzy, and then I was like, oh wait, it's an earthquake. So I just kind of sat down for a bit thinking, like, you know, let's just wait until it passes, because I live on the 19th floor, so it's not really smart to try to take the elevators down. So I just kind of sat on my bed. It was the most safe location in my apartment, so I just sat there waiting for it to pass.
The earthquake rattled Taiwan's east coast, claiming the lives of at least 9 individuals. Rescuers are tirelessly working to free numerous others trapped under debris caused by landslide and collapsed structures. With over 900 reported injuries and more than 100 buildings damaged, authorities are grappling with the aftermath of one of Taiwan's strongest earthquakes in 25 years.
From my 19th floor apartment, most earthquakes that are above 5 would, like, really have an impact. Like, I would feel like I'm swaying, like I'm in a hammock kind of feeling. Which is quite uncomfortable, but this one was a lot more intense because more things were shaking. Like, behind me I have, like, shelves, but you can't really see them. But my shelves, things that I have on my shelves, some of things fell down. Some of the carvings and stuff that I have up in my apartment fell down. So that made me realize, you know, this might be a bit intense. I just kept hearing, like, rattling, and I have a mirror on my cupboard, and that kept, like, rocking vigorously back and forth. So it kind of made me realize maybe this is a serious one. And also the duration of it, it was a lot longer than the usual earthquakes that I've experienced since living here.
Wagner is one of many Belizeans living in Taiwan. She says that she got in contact with those she knows to ensure that they are safe. There have been 29 aftershocks since the quake. Forecasts suggest that tremors as powerful as magnitude 7 could occur in the coming days. The earthquake resulted in power cuts affecting more than 91,000 households. Despite this experience, Wagner says she has not reevaluated her stay in Taiwan.
I've reached out to the people that I am close to, and most of them have expressed that they're okay. We see, I think Hualien is one of the greatest locations that's been impacted. I've reached out to the Belizeans that I know there, and most of them are okay. Well, the ones that replied to me that I interact with have said they're fine and everything is okay, but they post on their stories saying, you know, they're nearby where some of the buildings collapse and stuff like that.
Have this experience made you reevaluate whether you want to continue living there?
I think, short answer, no, because I feel like anywhere in the world that you choose to live, there are natural disasters that you have to contend with. In Belize, we have hurricanes, here's earthquakes and earthquakes and typhoons, and you just have to learn how to coexist with these natural elements. So I don't think it should be a deterrent for anybody, and for me personally, no.
On X, Prime Minister John Briseno shared, quote, "Our thoughts are with the government, people, and our friends of Taiwan," end of quote. The Belizean embassy in Taiwan saying that it responded immediately by liaising with Belizean students located in different regions in Taiwan, as well as universities where Belizean students are studying, to confirm that they are safe. The embassy also said that while some Belizeans are understandably shaken emotionally, there has been no report of any material effects on them. Reporting for News 5, Hippolyta Novello.
Belize Electricity Limited wants the mean electricity rate to remain fixed at 40 cents per kilowatt hour throughout the 2024 to 2028 tariff cycle. BEL officially made the request to the Public Utilities Commission, PUC, on March 22nd. BEL says this aligns with its overarching mission to provide safe, reliable, and sustainable energy solutions that bolster quality of life, productivity, and national development. BEL's proposal is backed by four reasons, including the introduction of new tariffs and pricing structures for electric vehicle charging, the retrieval of outstanding balances from prior periods, and the allocation of over $500 million towards capital projects over the ensuing 5 years. The PUC says that a public hearing will be held on Thursday, April 11th at 6 p.m. at the Belize Biltmore Plaza. No sugar, no water, just pure healthy juice. This is what Marheli Alvarado, owner of Juice by Mar, told us when we asked about the contents of her cold-pressed juices, which are currently making waves across the country. Alvarado is hoping that she can get her juices to even more children by making them available in schools. News 5's Brittany Gordon reports.
Belize City resident Marheli Alvarado has been making juices for over 6 years, and in August 2023, she decided to launch Juiced by Mar, her very own company, to provide Belizeans with cleaner, healthier juices. In alignment with that goal, she launched Juice for Kids.
I have a dream and a vision that I want to see make an impact in Belize.
So what is that dream?
So last year in July, the Ministry of Education started a Healthy Schools, Healthy Belize campaign. And mainly that is to eliminate sugary drinks from our primary school kids' diet. And since I've been doing cold fresh juices for the past 6 years, I was like, wow, this can't be like the perfect opportunity. How can it be a coincidence for me, you know? My dream and the vision that I have is to see my juices in all schools in Belize City, not only in Belize City, but countrywide. It's not something that I want to keep for myself, but I want everybody to benefit from it, especially our kids. Mm-hmm. It's hard for us as adults to get out of our habitual ways that we're stuck in, but it's easier to work with our primary school children, right?
Alvarado stated that her products are made from locally sourced produce.
So you said that this is cold pressed juices. What is a cold pressed juices exactly, and what makes your juice stand out from all the other natural juices that we see for sale in the market? What makes my juice stand out? First of all, we don't have any heat added to the process. Secondly, cold press is a process of blending fruits and veggies. So you're actually extracting the juice from a fruit and a vegetable, and you have to have a ratio of 60 to 40. It all depends on what you want to select, right? Mm-hmm. So there's no water or sugar added to the process. And when I say no water, I mean 0% water, 0% added sugars, and 0% preservatives. So it's all natural, just the way as nature intended it to be. Mm-hmm.
The Juice for Kids brand offers three flavors, all themed around superheroes. Each bottle includes a fun fact about the ingredients' benefits. Alvarado says that her goal is to prevent diabetes in children in Belize and hopes that these juices will make it into schools with the help of the government.
So for now, the brand only has three different flavors. I have a Captain Carrots blend that is carrots with orange juice, mm-hmm. and I also have a Mr. Coca Pina. So on each of my bottles, there's a superhero in a vegetable form, you know, like a cartoon character to appeal to the children. And the third brand is actually a Mrs. Apple, which is green apples, cucumber, and pineapple, which I'm going to make on set today. And I came up with these brands
We were simply in, where I was in San Pedro, those three juices were our top sellers. Mm-hmm. And so from 10, why not just narrow it down to 3, which is the average juice that, you know, consumers would purchase on a daily basis.
Alvarado offers a variety of flavors, including activated charcoal, which is made from locally sourced coconut husk. She also offers custom orders. Brittany Gordon for News 5.
After the break, Belize's heat wave to be broken by cold front. But first, here's a weather update with data from the National Meteorological Service.
La formación del Centro Neurológico del Hospital Galenia es que esas enfermedades que son altamente complejas y que muchos de nuestros pacientes tenían que emigrar hacia otra parte de la República u otra parte de México ahora puedan ser atendidos aquí.
La atención quirúrgica en el Centro Neurológico se forma dentro de un grupo multidisciplinario que incluye tanto neurólogos, médicos internistas, ortopedistas, neurocirujanos, pediatras. Y este esfuerzo que se ha realizado para conjuntar todos los especialistas es para siempre brindar al paciente un abordaje multidisciplinario y transversal.
Evidentemente, mientras más rápido podamos llegar al diagnóstico de los pacientes, más rápido podemos tratarlos, resolverlos y por ende mejor resultado vamos a tener al final. Entonces creo que la prioridad y el fundamento principal de un proyecto como este es justamente eso, que no se pierda tiempo de forma innecesaria para poder al final del día llegar al mejor de los resultados con un tratamiento completo, integral y oportuno.
Y las visiones desde diferentes perspectivas nos permiten tener pues el mejor tratamiento y la mejor opción para el paciente.
Tenemos la capacidad técnica, operativa, profesional y la infraestructura de poder establecer una atención neurológica de alta calidad.
The phasing out of single-use plastics and the enactment of pollution from the plastics regulations. One of the key components in this regulation states that for an item to be considered biodegradable, it must consist of more than 50% of bio-based content. Here, you will find out how the Department of the Environment determines what items meet the criteria and what equipment is being used to guide that process.
Since 2019, the Department of the Environment has been working with CIFAS in doing microplastics. Through this project, CIFAS has donated 2 microscope Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy equipment to strengthen capacities on monitoring and enforcement to reduce marine litter and plastic pollution. The FTIR can be used to identify unknown materials. The Department of the Environment will use the equipment to determine the composition of single-use plastics and biodegradable products to enforce the environmental protection, pollution from plastics regulations.
While we have a long way to go with the implementation of the pollution from plastics regulation, having this equipment is one step closer. For more information on what's being done about biodegradables and ways you can help, visit our website at www.doe.gov.bz.
It seems like every other day, we hear of a family member or friend being diagnosed with a serious illness such as cancer, heart attack, kidney failure, or stroke. When these illnesses strike, you want to focus on recovery and your overall well-being.
At RFNG Life Insurance, we offer critical illness insurance to help with medical expenses when diagnosed with such critical illnesses, providing security to access quality healthcare facilities and to ease the worry about finances. In case you are diagnosed with a life-threatening illness that is covered by the policy, critical illness insurance pays you a lump sum amount to help you obtain access to quality treatment and medication. Having critical illness insurance provides the financial support that will bring you and your family the security and peace of mind necessary to manage these illnesses. The possibility of being diagnosed can be worrying, but by having a critical illness plan, you could have funds to assist with expenses such as medications, hospital deductibles, childcare, household expenses, and so much more. The right time to plan for the unexpected is when you're healthy. For more information, visit our office today to speak with one of our experienced agents about critical illness insurance. Your health and wellness is what matters most. Take care of it.
Belizean. Of course, I'll make sure the place clean, especially the places then where we treasure.
Adawa Belizean, of course I have a bag for my garbage in my car.
Adawa Belizean, of course, I believe that all of we should do for we part to protect the environment.
Adawa Belizean, of course I teach my picnic from small enough to throw garbage on the ground.
Adawa Belizean, of course, on and off the court. We unite as a team to keep Belize clean.
As Belizeans, let's trash the habit and not the beauty.
A Belize City man was arraigned today for harm after he allegedly assaulted his girlfriend because she refused to have intercourse with him. The incident happened on March 1st, and the accused is 23-year-old Kenyon Flores. The woman says when she refused Flores' advances, he got angry and accused her of cheating. That is when Flores allegedly choked her and slammed her head on a table while hitting her several times in the face. She told police that she got a knife and cut Flores in the knee to defend herself. Flores was brought before the magistrate's court this afternoon to answer to a single charge of harm. He pleaded not guilty. There was no objection to bail, but the prosecutor did ask the court to set bail conditions to protect the complainant. That is when Flores flipped the story and told the court that his girlfriend stabbed him because he got a text on his phone. We briefly heard from Flores outside the courtroom.
You sure don't want to talk to me? You don't want to tell me your side?
Bless.
Hey, man. All right?
They don't do any dooming. You don't please themselves by stabbing me.
Why? Why the girl stab you? Please give me your side.
You stab me because my phone call me come in. She get back scanning and call me and she send me disrespectful, so you stab me.
You know what, girlfriend relationship?
Yeah.
Flores was granted bail in the sum of $1,000 plus one surety of the same amount, which he met. Flores' next court date is set for May 16th. On Tuesday, the National Meteorological Service issued a heat alert warning the public that the temperatures were expected to exceed 97 degrees Fahrenheit. Since then, Belize has experienced extreme levels of heat, with some areas rising to 103 degrees Fahrenheit. Fortunately, temperatures are expected to fall as a cold front is predicted to pass over the country on Thursday. As conditions continue to change, the National Meteorological Service of Belize is advising all to remain mindful and vigilant of the weather. We spoke with the chief meteorologist, Ronald Gordon, for an update.
We issued a heat alert starting yesterday, and it continues today. We issue those heat alerts whenever temperatures inland are expected to exceed 97 degrees Fahrenheit. Currently, or what we observed yesterday, was that temperatures varied from about 90 along coastal areas to the lower hundreds inland. So for example, in Central Farm, we recorded 102 degrees Fahrenheit, and the highest was in Char Creek, which was 103 degrees Fahrenheit. These are from our network of automatic weather stations. They are not quality checked as such as yet, so they are preliminary data, but certainly they give us an indication of how hot it was, and that is the reason why we issued those heat alerts. We are expecting a cold front to come over our area later tonight, and so we will see temperatures decrease a bit. Therefore, today is actually the last day for this particular heat wave. Tomorrow should be a bit cooler. It's not going to be cold. It's not a cold front like in December, but certainly it's going to be a relief from the extremely hot conditions that we are currently experiencing. One of the measures that we advise our residents to do, of course, is to remain hydrated. You drink a lot of water, fresh juices. You avoid going out into the direct sunlight if possible. I know that's not possible for everyone, but if you can avoid it, try to avoid it as much as possible. If you're able to get some sort of shading, try to take that. And of course, the clothes that you wear as well. Try to wear clothes that will be a bit cooler and that type of thing. And then we advise, of course, for persons to look out for each other, especially our elderly, vulnerable population, people with disability, and young children, and even our pets. So certainly we need to be very caring of others at this time. Heat exhaustion and heat stress is real. It can have devastating impact, and it can be even fatal. So certainly we advise residents to take these precautions and take them seriously.
More intense heat waves are one of the effects of climate change. And as Belize continues to bolster efforts towards climate resilience, extreme weather conditions worsen. Belize and other small island developing states emit the least amount of carbon into the atmosphere, but still experience the most impacts. Last year, the world observed one of the hottest days in recorded history. And according to the World Meteorological Organization, there is a high probability that this year will break the record. We spoke with Chief Meteorologist Ronald Gordon to hear what the trends are looking like moving forward.
Well, when you look at the longer-term climate trend, it is very clear that we are in an era where our temperatures are warming up. There is no denying that. So certainly, in the long term, we are seeing an increase in temperatures due to climate change, due to human-induced climate change, to be specific. However, there's a thing called climate variability. So there will be exceptional years where it's going to be extremely hot other than other years. You will have other years where the temperatures will dip a bit. So it's the natural variability within the climate system. Last year in particular was extremely hot for two reasons. Of course, I mentioned we have human-induced climate change, which is causing temperatures to increase. But on top of that, we had an El Nino year, which means that conditions are actually hotter and warmer, and drier, in our area. So certainly those factors combined resulted in a very hot year last year. And what we are seeing right now, based on the current trend, is that we're also heading for a very hot year. I must mention that on the short term, I'm doing two things here. So on the short term, which is the weather scale, we are going to see things changing a bit over the next few hours. Indeed, looking at what we have done already to the climate system, it is very difficult to say that we can reverse the impacts. Certainly we can alleviate, and that is what is being done, I believe, at the regional and the international level to try to mitigate the impacts, no? By reducing, of course, our carbon footprint. However, there is already a lot of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, and those take some time to actually come out of the atmosphere. They have a long life as such. Therefore, even if we cut emissions at this point, there will be some continuing heating and warming up of the atmosphere. So to answer your second point, I believe you mentioned that we need to adapt. And that's certainly one of the measures that we take in our region, because as most of us know, we are not a major emitter. So countries like ours, we are not the culprit, so to speak, for what is occurring. So one of the things that we are encouraged to do is to adapt to the effects of climate change.
Residents of Bullet Tree Village in the Kayo District say they have been having water issues for quite some time. They say that they have no idea what to do as they have had limited to no access to potable water for over a month. One resident, Dale Holder, told News 5 that the village might be facing this problem due to development and population expansion. He says that the village is supplied with water through a pump that is connected to a reserve. Holder says he has been without water for the past 2 weeks.
We've had water issues ever since I've lived here. That's just normal. I found in Belize, and you know, the whole area has water issues. But they have developed a new area here in next to the village, the government has, and they expanded. So when they expanded, before they did the expansion, they put new system up on the hill, put new tanks and everything. And since they're developing the other areas around here, the people here have lost some of their water supply. And I hear different things about they don't have a pump big enough to pump now. And I've tried to catch up with the local chairman. And I finally caught up with him later this afternoon, just around noon. And he said he would meet with me because I'm trying to find out from him and secondhand. I've never been able to catch up on him. He hadn't been able to return my calls for some reason. But the near area, there's quite a few people. I don't know how many is over in that area now, 500 to 1,000 people. And the very first part of the new area is getting water, from what I understand. And other than that, they aren't getting any water. We lucked out first night, must have been Saturday night. We got about 50 gallons of water, but I stayed up all night to get that and to haul it up. But, you know, we are getting some. There's other people that aren't getting any. We are getting some now. I've been able to pump up a few times to the storage tank. The other people in the village don't have access to an additional pump or anything, and they don't. They have no water. It's dry right now. You know, a lot of them collect water and they have water for haul, but the area person here does a lot of the hauling of water. He's booked solid. He couldn't even get it to me because I needed water and we were out. And so it's becoming a problem for the local people that we can't get water unless they can go to the river and get it themselves and bring it in.
When we return, San Pedro resident left desperate amidst land dispute.
The Mega Bingo Progressive Jackpot has been getting bigger and it's now all the way up to $378,525. It's time to get in the game so you can have your chance at all that mega cash. Be sure to get your tickets for the next show airing on Wednesday, April 3rd on Channel 5 and Love FM at 8 p.m. or catch it online. Log in to YouTube or Facebook and search for Belize Mega Bingo. Don't miss it. You can be the next one to win that mega progressive jackpot. All that cash can make your dreams come true. And remember, Mega Bingo is the game.
Design Depot, your all-in-one destination for transforming your living spaces. Explore the world of GE with our selection of cutting-edge appliances for functional, convenient, and modern living. Find solutions for every paint project, from home to industrial, with our extensive selection of Sherwin-Williams paints and coatings. Safeguard your home with the durability of our weather-resistant windows and doors. Elevate your kitchen and bath with the timeless elegance of Kohler sinks and faucets. Transform your space with our constantly refreshed tile inventory, always embracing the latest tile trends. Design Depot, your source for innovation, inspiration, and impeccable design. Design Depot, all in one place.
upcoming enhancements to My Social Security. The new healthcare provider feature seamlessly connects healthcare providers, insured persons, and employers to facilitate the payment of sickness benefits. Here are the enhancements. Registered healthcare providers will create and submit online medical certificates using their healthcare provider accounts. Insured persons will receive a link to view the medical certificate to complete and submit their sickness benefit claim. And employers will receive an email notification of their employee's sickness claim. Also, the insured person and their employer will receive a copy of the claim decision letter after review. Healthcare providers, insured persons, and employers are encouraged to create a portal account to access and benefit from these new services on My Social Security at ssbportal.org.bz. My Social Security Online Portal. Social Security at your fingertips.
For 19 years, SMART has been the pulse of our nation. A journey of growth, innovation, resilience, and unity.
From the first call that bridged distances to the data that brought us closer than ever, SMART has been there, weaving threads of connection across our beautiful land.
We have been active in providing innovative solutions to enhance our customers' lifestyles. Over the years, SMART has developed and provided various services to meet customers' needs.
To the dreamers, doers, and the believers, thank you for making SMART a part of your story. For 19 years of trust, loyalty, partnership, and shared experiences.
As we celebrate 19 years of connecting lives and dreams, let's keep the rhythm alive. Together, let's continue to shape our future one connection at a time.
Come and be a part of the SMART family, where we empower you and our country today, tomorrow, and beyond.
SMART, bringing people together.
Hi, my name is Lincoln Forrest, and I work at UMall. 100% I will recommend Belize Bank mobile banking to everyone because it saves time, money, and gas price, because gas price is high right now. Belize Bank mobile banking just make life easier.
A San Pedro man is claiming that he is being denied access to his land on the island. 58-year-old Victor Gautier and his wife separated in 2020, but still live at the same address. He claims that he is being denied access to enter their shared business, Gautier Fruit Shop, or to receive any profits from it. According to Gautier, the land is his and all efforts to get authorities involved have failed. This is why he turned to the media to seek assistance.
My issue is I concern my piece of land in San Pedro. I have an issue with my ex-wife. We have a problem with the front of the land, the business that two of us own. But the thing is that she seems like she wants to be the one who want have more rights over the land than me. And that's why I told her. I tell her the problem is here, I own the land. And the way she talk, the way how she want, well, the way I see how she want though, like she just want to kick me out of the place and not make me have no rights for the piece of place. And got me that back, and only she have rights over the business.
And are you two officially separated yet?
Well, I go through the process right now. It's not really official like that, but then the problem is that this problem here, she continue doing things inside the place without my concern. And they make noise in the place. And so the last time I come for work, I hear a lot of noise. And so I tell them that where are the problem there? First thing, they got a police there. They mind the business. And the police tell me the boss lady come and tell me to come out of my own place. I don't have nothing against the police. He's doing a job, but he don't know where they go on there. Like that's why he don't ask me where they go. No, that boss lady want take me out of my place. That really make a girl pissed. Because I say, me like the one who build this place, yeah. hold on to somebody just to come and take me out and, you know, and tell me just come out of it. And that way me really get leave upset about.
So are you still having any involvement in the business at all? Are you still receiving any income from that?
No kind of income. I have nothing to do with it. That's how they treat me like I don't nobody. And that way really concerned me too. And the next thing where she do, she want put maintenance for me and make me maintain the kids. I don't have nothing wrong with maintaining the kids. But how is she, the way I see it, if she want make me maintain the kids and she must have the business, so I don't understand what she want try to do with me.
Thousands of amnesty applications are still being reviewed. The government says that applications for 12,765 migrants from 32 countries are still being vetted in collaboration with the Ministry of Home Affairs and New Growth Industries. The new expected date of completion is the end of September 2024. Stakeholders are reminded that the valid White Amnesty Program receipt, that is a legal document entitling migrants to remain and work in the country until a final decision is made on their application. The amnesty program is being implemented for the purposes of national security, managing migration, economic development, and humanitarian assistance. And that's the news. Tonight's broadcast is available at channel5belize.com, on our Facebook, and on YouTube. I'm Sabrina Daly. Thanks for joining us. And from all of us here at News 5, good night.